These comfort of our life. The scientist is engaged. The artist is engaged. The engineer is engaged. The technician is engaged. All in different branches of human activities. But they do not know how to make the activities purposeful to fulfill the mission of human life. Because they do not know this secret. All their activities are targeted towards the goal of sense gratification without control. And therefore, by all this business, they are unknowingly entering into the deep regions of darkness. Because they have been captivated by the external energy of the Supreme Lord, they have completely forgotten the Supreme Lord Vishnu. Thus they have taken it for granted that this life, as presently manifested under the condition of material nature, is all in all for enjoying the highest amount of sense gratification. But such a wrong conception of life cannot give anyone the desired peace of mind. And thus, in spite of all advancement in knowledge, by use of the resources of nature, no one is happy in this material civilization. The secret is that at every step, they should try to execute sacrifices toward the path of world peace. Bhagavad Gita also advises the same secret in the following verses. Svai svai karma nivirata sansiddhi labhate na sakarma nirata siddhi yatha vinnati tachinu yanta pravitti bhutana yena sarva. Facilities according to his personal propensity. End of quote from Bhagavad Gita. There is no harm in having different propensities in life because every human being is proportionately independent to jog out the plan of his life by different occupations. But one should make it a point in his life to know perfectly well that he is not independent. Absolutely. One is certainly under the control of the Supreme Lord and under different agencies. Knowing this, one should make it a point that by his work and the result of his labor, he serves the Supreme Lord as prescribed by the authorities expert. The transcendental loving service of the Supreme Lord Vishnu. For performing such occupational duties of life, the leg is the most important instrument of the body, because without the help of the leg, one cannot move from one place to another. And therefore, the Lord has special control over the legs of all human beings, which are meant for performing yajna. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta Swami translation and purport of Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 2, Chapter 2, Text 25, in the manner of the Bhagavatam is the answer to all questions. Hari. By walking in the Rath Yatra, we can see that the legs are needed to perform Rath Yatra Yajna. ideally. We didn't have legs, how would we pull the rug? Interesting point here. Occupational duties are meant to be performed for the pleasure of Krishna. If the occupational duties don't please Krishna, then human life is not fulfilled. It's not a success. Yesterday, the Puri Bhakt Swamiji also told the people, if you haven't developed your attachment for Krishna, by end of life, your life is not a success. People make artificial standard of what success is. In India, it's having children and putting your children through education and having a house. These kind of things. What is it in America, Anujama? Lots of money, nice house, nice family, swimming pool. Mercedes-Benz, nice car. So, the American way is promoting this all over the world. So Prabhupada raises the point here, people work very hard in order to be comfortable. But in spite of all the hard efforts, people are not happy if they're not Krishna conscious. They're feeling something is missing in their life. When we were starting the Mayapur construction development, we didn't have much money. Whatever money Prabhupada sent had to be spent according to his direction. So we didn't have a vehicle. No jeep, no vehicle. So, but I had a bicycle. So I would ride to Krishna Nagar on my bicycle to order the construction supplies and have it sent to Mayapur by horse buggy or by truck, depending how much the quantity was. So when I was bicycling, I take my bicycle across the Jalangi River. It was the fastest way, and sometimes I would cycle around. That took 1 hour and 15 minutes. If I took my cycle across the river and cycled, it would take 45 minutes. So we cycled to Krishna Nagar. On the way, I could sing Hare Krishna. What else to do while you're bicycling? So I've been singing for 45 minutes. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. I was very happy. I remember one time I got off my bicycle and I went went into the biggest hardware store of the city. He was our life member. He used to have more steel nuts and bolts, screws, all kind of metal goods, paints. So I was buying some hardware to use for our construction in my airport. So after getting off the bicycle, I was smiling, I was very happy. Oh, good morning, sir, how are you? And he looked at me. He said, why are you happy? You have nothing. You only have a bicycle. I have two cars. I have a three-story house. I have a wife, children, money. I'm the richest man in this city. Why you're happy? Why are you not happy? You couldn't figure it out because this is what they've been told. You have a big house, you have the family, you have the cars. Same formula, America and India. This is what they've been trained. If you have these things, you're going to be happy. But he wasn't happy. And here comes somebody with nothing and his destination. No big house, no big car, no family, bicycle. Why is he happy? People that don't know the secret to what is happiness. That we actually become happy by serving Krishna. What he was failing to do was perform sacrifice for the pleasure of Krishna. I was thinking that the day that came out in the newspapers that they performed Rath Yatra for world peace. And here Prabhupada said, the secret is that in every they should try to execute sacrifice toward the path of world peace. So somebody asked, why is Rath Yatra for world peace here? Every step we take is for world peace. Sacrifice. It's a worthy goal. Because of the raw understanding of what makes people happy. If people aren't happy, they won't be peaceful. They're thinking, I'm not happy because I don't have as much as America does. I'm not happy because I don't have what my neighbor has. So then they fight with their neighbors, fight with other countries. Recently, not yesterday, after being on safari, I turned on the BBC for a half hour. The president of Taiwan was shot in the stomach, along with the vice president while campaigning. I don't know yet who did it. Then let's see what else. Bombing in Pakistan. It's the news, it's all over. Wars are going on, people are being shot. And after 5 years of peace in Kosovo, now the Albanian Kosovites are burning the houses of the Serbs. And the Serbs are burning the mosques of the Albanians. And the Albanians are burning the churches of the Orthodox Serbians. And so on and so forth, back and forth. And you don't know, they have the UN there, they have international peacekeeping. But there's no peace. It's a failure. Because they don't go to the root issue. A whole world conception is wrong. everybody see each other based on their bodily, racial, religion, sectarian differences. Krishna consciousness offers us a universal alternative. See everybody as members of the same divine family, Vasudeva Kutumbakam. So this is what's the problem. If people are performing, everyone understands there's one supreme Lord, we all need to sacrifice for him. So why should there be fights between Serbs and Albanians? Why should there be so much terrorism? So, there don't seem to be any solution on the BBC or the CNN. We're going out in our humble way, and people say, what are you doing for world peace? Why does marching in Bangalore help world peace? Everything helps. This is a powerful vibration that can change the whole world. When we march in Mayapur, a parikrama, that has a very big effect, not only for world peace, but for world liberation. Our previous acharyas have told us we can liberate the entire world. Distributing these books. So many of you are distributing books. How many distributed a book during this safari? Have we tried to distribute a book to this book? Thank you all very much. Because now, science has come up with a new theory on how even a little thing can create a big change. They say that if a butterfly is flying in the Amazon and goes from left to right, suddenly changes the way, and that creates a little wind which will affect another wind which affects another wind, which means that in the Atlantic Ocean there's a hurricane going on because of the butterfly flying from one way to the other. That hurricane doesn't hit Virginia. Instead, it hits North Carolina. Or Florida, or goes out to the sea and doesn't get any more. Hits the Virgin Islands or something. So they say, so if that is a modern scientific new theory, that even a butterfly is flapping, change hurricanes. What to speak of one Bhagavad Gita. Maybe that person was going to go out and 5 years from now was going to shoot somebody, become a terrorist. And by reading Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, he said, wait a minute. In Peru, there's a terrorist group called the Sendero Luminoso. They call the Path of Light. But they were murdering so many thousands of people for a while. They're still there, but then they're much reduced now. And one time, they came to our temple to see one of these Hare Krishnas. And they saw that our children were singing and chanting. They saw that the devotees are chanting. And then one of them came over and talked to the president. I am Sendero Luminoso. I am the shining path. We have come here to check you out. I just want to tell you, this is the first place in my life I've ever been to where I see the that people are happy. Because I'm seeing this, I'm wondering, why am I killing people? That maybe there is a way, that I want to leave this and now look at also after visiting your temple. But if I join you here, I'll be killed. So I have to leave here, go to some other country, and then join and become Hare Krishna. So just by one arti, watching one kirtan. So we cannot, Prabhupada said that this ringing of the bell and arti is more powerful than nuclear bomb. Stop the recycle of birth and death. But these ringing of the arti bell, ding, 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 that can end somebody's cycle of birth and death. That can make them liberated. It's the one arti, one view of devotees. A man decided to change his life from terrorism devotional service. So ours is a difficult path. You don't always see the effects immediately. But we have to have that faith that the effects are there. We are seeing many effects. You're seeing so many devotees here, you're seeing so many people whose lives have changed. It would be very nice, today we don't have so many programs, to get to know more of the devotees. Usually when we do programs, they don't have so many cultural programs, but in this safari, the organizers always had Bharatnatyam, Ramayana, so many different programs. That we don't always, we didn't get to meet and hear from so many other devotees. As I go around, at least individually, everyone should try to meet a new devotee on the safari every day. Maybe you can have the different nations meet. The Russian speakers meet with the Spanish speakers through your translators. Get to know each other. Get to know how we are one big family under Prabhupada, under Krishna. Get to know each other. This is the opportunity. We're together for 3 weeks. We still have another more than a week together. Almost an hour halfway through. How many of you have been able to meet somebody else on the safari through this time? That's pretty good. How many? The Russians, nobody raised their hand. Nobody met anybody new. A few. Ajay, Abhiram Thakur, Lalita, Charanani, Mayapureshwari, Tulsi, Rudini, few men. We want to, this is our friendship program. We want to, of course we get to meet the Prabhupada disciples and the senior devotees. Get to hear Tapasya Das's ecstatic kirtans, Bhakta Peter's dramas and kirtan uttamas, pastimes of Prabhupada. When we go to Hyderabad, we can hear more Hyderabad pastimes. To know that Krishna consciousness, how it's working around the world. We're not the only ones who are experiencing bliss. We're not the only ones who have to face difficulties. All around the world, we have similar situations, and Krishna consciousness is working, whether it's a light properly. Today I saw Indian Express and Hindu. We have front page picture on one of them. Two other picture on us. Nice pictures, good articles. See, this safari has been a big media success, local success. We want it to be a personal success for each one of you. Thank you very much. Thank you for all of Bangalore devotees. Surprise, so few Bangalore devotees here. Seems they had to work late last night. Any question? Esther?
Minimum speed. They say if you
don't reach that speed, then the airplane will stall and fall from the sky. If you're ever in an airplane and the wings start to shake and the whole plane starts to quiver, you look like you're going very slow. Some pilot disciples told me that's the sign you're about ready to fall out from the air. You better start praying. The only solution then is the pilot has to turn on the gas, has to turn on the accelerator and go fast. And somehow through the wind pocket, due to some, they slow down too much and they have to go faster, otherwise they'll crash. So this is also in our own devotionals, so we have to keep flying. It may be very easy to fly in a big festival. But when we're on our own, then we have to learn how to be our preacher, how to be always active. If you're not able to do that, then we're in nature. Then we need a better association. We're trying to train our congregational devotees that they can also be preachers through Bhakti Riksha, through Namahatta, through different house programs. They can also be active preachers. By being an active, very active all the time in Krishna service, you feel happy. Some of them think, I just want to relax. But sometimes too much comfort means you lose your spiritual taste. Devotees don't want to be too much comfortable. They want to be always engaged in Krishna's service. If you have that minimum level of engagement, you can keep flying, you'll be happy. But if you reduce your service too much, you'll reach the stall level and your happiness will crash. Sometimes the guru or some sannyasi visits. So it says one of the duties of the renounced people is to visit the grihasthas, gives them some opportunity to serve, brings up their activity level, which is devotional service, gives them some good association so that they can keep flying. Some temples, they complain nobody visits. You get no association. They get lots of association. They feel the temple's more blissful. So Prabhupada had a mission to be traveling sannyasis, traveling preachers, to be regular programs. All these things are needed to keep our enthusiasm up. And coming to festivals is part of it. Maintaining and maintaining a certain level, but occasionally go to a festival, it boosts up, makes it that much easier. Eventually we want to reach such a level, we're just flying high altitude. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Sorry I was late, I got one of these emergency calls from Gopal Krishna Maharaj. Say I have to help him in managing his God India problems. Hare Krishna.
Maharaj ki.
Our Bangalore temple now in hands of the rich people.
Might as well in a circle.
¿Qué fue el primer maestro espiritual que conocí de Nisa?
Hari Hari Bo.
Dale la mano, bro.
Voy a aprovechar para...
Sí.
Charlanda Prabhu de Nueva Zelanda, sabía dónde hacerlas bien, estilo ISKCON, mármol, porque los devotos de Tijuana pues siempre, nunca venimos muy seguido a India y me dijeron que aprovechara para hacer alguna deidad o algo, para que estuvieran ahí y engancharlo mejor, aprovechando que pues, misericordia me dio.
Horrible.
Iniciación y...
Sal.
Quería darle... pedirle el consejo y...
Todo mucho, ¿no? ¿Mexicano?
No.
¿Qué hace?
Guare.
No soy autoridad local de Tijuana. Es...
No las pensamos instalar simplemente para que estén, para podernos enganchar mejor y en algún momento dado ofrecerles mejor algo.
Bueno, ayudar, pero cualquier permiso debe tomar de guardias.
Sí, lo que hacemos, Camila, ya sabe y nos apoyó mucho.
Seguro que están durmiendo todos.
Entonces, ¿usted qué nos dice? ¿Todo bien?
Which
one?
11.
Is your bed?
No, way down there.
Mm-hmm. 10:30, I can do some rest. 4:30.
Basta. Basta.
So enough time to get off.
By 38 minutes. Morning. Every morning by 38 will reach.
Last stop.
Last stop.
Waiting for everyone to get off, and when he decided to come down, the train just left. When we arrived in,
Prabhu is, hey, Prabhu, are you here or there? ¿Eh?
No, 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 porque yo no entiendo a veces que son 3 minutos.
So we are here in Hyderabad.
Thank you.
How about the disciples?
They're from our house, the other white car.
The other white. Hey, it's over here. How do you do with the
I told before safari. A lot of people listen.
I remember your yatra window, midnight, 12 o'clock, when train started moving and devotees, they did not went inside. A lot of disturbances.
What's that in my shoes, bro?
She's one lady.
Thank you.
See, they know automatically know which bus to go. One, actually, we call it one. Two is Nitya Nanda. They know by the number. He's going to their respective buses. I think that's international bus. And one is only for Russians, one is only for ladies. They have it all worked out. Because Russians, only 3-4 people speak English. So it's complicated.
Maybe after going there, we can walk over to the same buses. And we can tell Marichi and then we can walk over. One for home, two for home.
We have a number like that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
Yeah, all have the number. We know, everyone knows. Everyone knows how about...
Deputy Station Master, come to receive you all.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
She comes from Mexico.
Hare Krishna. Peru.
These two are from Peru.
Hare Krishna.
This is our Latin
woman. Most people there is Spanish people in this bus.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
This one? Colombia.
Argentina.
Hare Krishna.
Colombia.
He's from Colombia.
Colombia too.
Oh, he's very proud about it.
Have you said?
I'm not proud.
Mafia? He's from America.
He's Mafia.
Hare Krishna. We've already met.
Spiritual Mafia.
This is our senior devotee.
Prabhupada disciple.
Direct disciple of Bhaktivedanta. What a messenger to receive you.
Oh,
he's from Los Angeles, Greg Prabhupada, disciple.
Hare Krishna.
Gokul Ananda from Vancouver, Canada.
How are you? Oh, it's a man.
And he's from Mexico, and he's an accomplished musician.
Venezuela.
Oh, excuse me, Venezuela. Rani Gopal Das.
Thank you.
First time for us in Hyderabad. I'm in Bangalore. I'm in Bangalore. I'm in Bangalore.
I'm in Bangalore. I'm in
Bangalore. I'm in Bangalore. I'm in Bangalore. I'm in Bangalore. I'm in
Bangalore. I'm in
Bangalore. I'm in
Thank you.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.